Hey guys, next Atelier Toriko tutorial, we'll be addressing books like these that think they can teach you how to draw. Do I like them? Not really. But the reason why is because I think they assume you're at a certain level and maybe you're missing some basics, or it's boring and you should go more advanced. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take one of these exercises and we're gonna go in both directions. Bienvenue tout le monde, prochain tuto de Atelier Toriko sur les livres qui enseignent à dessiner, que j'aime pas du tout parce qu'ils pensent savoir quel niveau tu as et peut-être tu as besoin de plus de base ou tu as besoin de quelque chose d'un peu plus compliqué. Alors, on va commencer par un chat. We're gonna start by a cat for all you cat lovers. Alors, on va commencer par des cercles, petits, moyens et grands, pour que vous compreniez qu'il y a un mouvement différent pour chaque taille. We're going to start with circles, because there's a different movement involved for different size circles. Everybody's going to have their own twist to it, but this is how I do it, and then feel free to do it in the way that makes you feel most comfortable. These are the basics. Alors, this is gonna be our circle sheet. Alors, prenez un papier de brouillon, some scrap paper. Small circles. The hand stays immobile. And look how many circles I'm drawing. If I were to draw just one, not gonna be very nice. If I draw 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and I get the one that I like the best, and I erase the lines that don't belong. So please draw two lines of small circles. Alors, pour les petits cercles, gardez la main sur la feuille. Ça bouge à peine. Et vous voyez que je fais quelques-unes, parce que si je fais qu'une seule, c'est pas très intéressant comme cercle. Et après, j'efface tous les petits bouts dont j'ai pas envie. Et c'est comme ça qu'on retrouve des petits cercles qui sont plus intéressants. Medium circles, cercles de taille moyenne. Je vais utiliser ma main pour stabiliser le cercle. Et en ce moment, je suis en train de bouger à peine ma coude. Et j'essaie de pas trop bouger l'épaule. So, I'm using the bottom of my hand to stabilize, barely moving my elbow and not really moving my shoulder much. So, they're going all over the place. It's okay. Cause now, come back. Choose the one I like the best. And I might. My personal preference is to use this part of my pinky. Everybody has a different way of holding their hand for this, I've noticed. So please find what anchors you the best. Trouvez la partie de votre main ou doigt qui vous stabilise le plus. Tout le monde a leur propre astuce pour ça. And this takes practice. Ça demande la répétition. I did not figure this movement out straight away. Chacun a leur propre façon de faire. Ça prend un peu de temps pour trouver ce qui te plaît le plus. Ok. Non. Petit. Medium. Moyen. And big, large. The Satisfaction of labeling things. Okay. Alors. Now, moi j'ai ces poteaux qui me dérangent un petit peu, mais... Feel free to turn the paper. Tournez la page si ça vous convient. Parfois ça aide mentalement. Et là, now I'm moving my shoulder. Là, je bouge mon épaule. The bigger the circle, the more challenging. You have more room for error. Le plus grand le cercle, le plus compliqué ça peut devenir. Parce qu'il y a plus de marge pour faire une erreur. I'm going in both directions. This is a personal preference. Draw as many as fit on your page. Every page is going to look different. Dessiner le plus possible. Why are we doing all these circles? Because a cat's head has a surprising amount of circles in it. Pourquoi on fait tellement de cercles? Parce que la tête d'un chat comprend beaucoup de cercles. Deuxième chose, second thing, pour les chats, des traits tout droits. Straight lines, always very handy. So, I'm going to be pulling, drawing the lines top to bottom like this. The second you go left to right, you got your body in the way. Here, lots of space. So, this is another good exercise before you start drawing circles and lines. Alors, je vais de haut en bas parce que je n'ai pas mon corps qui va me bloquer. And here as well, I'm going to pull a few lines. I'm going to draw a few lines. Once I get a feel for which line's the best, I might slow down a little. Alors, pour faire des traits, tout droit. Et encore une fois, ma main est assez posée. Je ne vais pas faire des traits comme ça, ça va gondoler. So again, my hand is firmly on the paper. Plus petit, c'est plus facile. Small is easy. Moyen, ça devient un peu plus compliqué. And long, you need quite a stable hand, il faut la stabilité dans la main. J'utilise assez de muscles. Je suis en train de bien utiliser les muscles dans mon bras pour garder le trait droit. Ok, alors pour le chat. On va aussi utiliser des traits moyens en horizontal. For this cat, we're also going to be using horizontal, shorter lines. Là, il faut pas nécessairement tourner la page parce que c'est pas très long que ça. Again, my hand stable on the paper. Encore une fois, ma main stable sur la feuille. Okay, let's start drawing our cat. And we're gonna start with those circles that we just learned. On va commencer par dessiner le chat. Et on va commencer par deux cercles. Un grand et un moyen. A big one and a medium one. So, let me show you the reference. This is a photocopy of the book I showed you earlier. This is gonna be the reference cat. And I'll be sure to post this page for you. Since it's a cat that's coming off the bottom of the page, I'm gonna put my oval pretty low on this A4. Puisque c'est un chat qui a la tête qui sort un peu de en bas, je vais placer l'ovale un peu plus bas sur la page. Ovale, cercle, it's almost a circle. So, here I go. On va le cercle. And I'm using the bottom part of my finger. J'utilise le petit doigt. Comme je vous ai dit. Et
they're happy with that. Je suis assez content avec ça. Le moyen, medium circle, for the, en français, museau, the mouth, is there a word for that? Cat experts, get back at me. Oh yeah, thank you for all the beautiful tulip drawings you guys did, wow. I did not expect that. That made me very happy. Alors, museau, c'est pas très central cette salle, j'étais trop en train de parler. It's talking too much, sorry. I'll fast forward through this. Petit singe, little monkey. Divided in two. Alors, là. That along lines, using the whole arm. Au milieu, in the middle. A line will erase later, on va effacer ça plus tard. Ok. Petit V, a little V for the nose. Little reference points. All animals, humans, just a bunch of circles, little reference points, and then we start to shape things. On commence toujours par des cercles, des petits points de référence avant de bien dessiner les choses. Because if one thing's wrong, your whole drawing is off. Alors, si vous utilisez la feuille de référence, cet angle-là, il faut bien vérifier sur la feuille quel angle. It's this angle right here, from the corner, here. It's not 45, 45 is here, it's a bit less. C'est pas 45 degrés, c'est un peu moins. 45, a bit less. Peut-être un peu plus haut. The only reason this is important is to get the size of the ears right as well. Et ça serait bien d'avoir les oreilles de même taille. So start to compare this, these two spaces. Now this triangle, is it going to be the same here? Il faut toujours bien comparer ce qu'on fait. Si on fait deux fois la même chose. Now the ears. Je vais faire un peu au pif. Going a little bit haphazardly. Hop. But then, après je vais mesurer. It's a little bit higher. Always. Comme ça. Tac. Pencil. And double check. Yeah, it's about there. Sorry. So the cat's ears are rounded here and straighter there. Alors, les oreilles d'un chat, c'est plus droit ici et un peu plus arrondi avec un petit bosse là. Là aussi. Plus droit, plus arrondi. Ok, maintenant. Les yeux, the eyes. So these are these small horizontal lines we were talking about earlier. Les petits traits en horizontal deviennent utiles maintenant. Les yeux d'un chat, c'est comme les yeux d'un humain. Il y a une forme légèrement amande. C'est plus rond que les yeux d'un humain, mais il y a un petit point ici et là. So, human eyes are similar. A cat eyes are similar to human eyes in the sense that they're not perfectly round, but cat's eyes are obviously rounder. Ça aide. It helps to cut it like this. You see where the two points are. It's a little bit of an almond shape. So I'm gonna stick it in here. Even if it overlaps, don't worry. I'm feeling that it needs to be a bit bigger. Si ça dépasse un petit peu, ne vous inquiétez pas. Les deux pointes en diagonale, the two points in a diagonal. meeting here. I'm gonna elaborate on the nose. Je vais un peu élaborer sur le nez. Hop. C'est pas très central. It's not very central. I'm gonna shift it over. Up. Parce que le visage d'un chat, c'est assez symétrique. The face of a cat is quite symmetrical, like that of a human. Comme un humain. Le nez. Il y a plein de petits. Oh, and here is almost like a triangular shape. That was the original triangular shape. But I'm gonna erase that again, because we don't need it anymore, on a plus besoin de ça. Après, la bouche, the mouth. Here I'm gonna measure it. So if that, those two rounded bits stop down there, put a line for reference. Measure, it's about here. I'm gonna put that same line here. See, our little horizontal lines come in quite handy. And boom. A little rounded triangle. Maintenant j'efface. Now I'm erasing just any of these lines I don't need. Because eyes, nose, and mouth, ears, it's the main features of cats, humans, dogs. Unnecessary lines. Okay. Now, I'm going to just tighten up some of these shapes. Not getting too dark just yet. Je vais un peu bien contourner les formes que j'ai sans aller trop gras. Just refining. See here, it's a little bit higher than the bottom of the ears, so we'll be adding some fur there later. J'ajoute un petit bout là. C'est pour la
fur. How do you say fur?
Fourrure. Okay. Hop. Voilà. There we go. And erase this. And the body. So, pour trouver ça, où ça tourne, je peux mettre mon crayon pour voir. I can put my pencil to see that it goes there-ish and there-ish, just after the ear. So if this oval keeps going, here-ish, là le coup. Petit chat. Là aussi, des envers là. It's gonna be over here-ish. Give him some more fur. Up. Now, for the fur, I tend to do a little haphazard. So I'll show you over here. It's just like, once in a while, I do a bit of that. So, this is fun, this is relaxing. Don't have to worry about being too precise. Ears, not so much fur. Here a bit. Just a little bit of contour. We'll come back and tighten it up later when we do the shading. Start here instead. eyes. I'm gonna make him a bit more symmetrical. Pupils. No zombie cats today. Is that the middle? Let's find out. So to find the middle, we do a little cross. I mean, maybe the cat's looking up, but this cat isn't. Little pointed oval, staring right back at you. Alors, pour trouver le milieu, on met un petit croix. Droit au milieu, nos petits traits en horizontal et en vertical. Et j'efface autour. I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller. Vous allez trouver dans la photocopie les différents yeux de chat. Feel free to play with the different eyes of the cats. If you want a cat who's so peaceful and in love with you, make the eyes a little bit bigger. The pupils, rather. Looks scary. I changed my mind. I'm gonna make it a bit smaller. Okay. And you can double check that they're on about the same height. Vérifier qu'ils sont sur le même plan. Voilà. And they should be about the same size, otherwise that's also a bit weird. Devrait être à peu près la même forme. Okay. There we go. Bye-bye lines. Okay. Now we get into the shading. Maintenant, les dégradés. Les ombres, les lumières. C'est tout gris. Peut-être ici, c'est un peu plus clair. Et la moustache, the whiskers, blanc. This can be done with a white pencil at the end or the corner of your eraser at the end. Not something like this. You need a square eraser. Alors ça peut, on peut le mettre avec un crayon blanc ou avec le coin d'une gomme comme ça. But here you see it's rounded, so maybe I'd want to cut it with a cutter. Là, pour le faire plus pointu, je le couperai et j'aurai quatre coins très définis pour pouvoir effacer ça. I'll show you guys later. So, I'm gonna go in and just shade all of it. I'm gonna go in the direction of the fur. Je vais dans la direction de les poils, pas la fourrure, les poils. Et j'utilise le côté de mon crayon. I'm using the side of my pencil, which is harder to do when it's... So always turn the page when it helps you out. N'hésitez pas à tourner la page quand ça vous aide. I'm going to put my line exercise underneath to be able to go on the edges. The fur is slightly radial. Here it's going down, here it's going to the left, here it's going up, etc. So I'm gonna give that the same effect with the base shading. Always very lightly using the side of the pencil. Toujours très légèrement, je vais aller Un motion qui est tout rond pour montrer les poils qui vont à droite, en haut, qui contournent le visage. And there's some fur sticking out here, so I'm not going to be shy about overlapping. Je vais là derrière aussi, parce qu'il y a la tête qui est un peu plus... Et là, here it's very very thin fur or none at all. So, là il n'y a pas tellement de poils. So I'm just gonna go at a diagonal. Je vais en diagonale pour suggérer que c'est arrondi. On the left like this. On the right like this. Pour sculpter l'intérieur. So, going at a diagonal. Sculpt the inside. Maybe I should have gone the other way. Yeah. Dans l'autre sens, c'était mieux. Okay. Now. Là, on a un ton gris assez uni. Et on va un peu revenir pour faire ressortir les ombres et les taches. So we're gonna come back and make the shadows pop out, some of the pattern. This cat has some nice patterns. So just going to repass. Maintenant je commence à montrer quelques poils. So I'm gonna show some of the fur. Pattern, not pattern, but a reference to individual hairs. Not doing this everywhere, because that's a pain in the butt. Just a little bit. No need to be a perfectionist. Just for 1 minute, guys. Or if you really want to draw every single little hair, and that it's very relaxing to you, which it's not for me. And send me that drawing. But if it drives you nuts, like me, don't do it. Alors, soyez autant perfectionniste que vous aimeriez être, tant que ça vous calme, tant que ça vous aide. C'est ça le but de ces dessins. C'est pas de vous stresser. Et dès que vous vous sentez crispé, the second you're like, I'm drawing and it's stressful. Buvez un peu de thé. Alors, I'm just going for it. I think at this point, il faut seulement suivre ces formes qui sont plus foncées. We're just following here as well. So, alors on plisse les yeux, we're squinting our eyes, we're seeing that this is dark, this shape is dark, and here it's just a little bit darker. On repasse pas où c'est clair, we're just not passing over the parts that were light. Similar to the tulip exercise, but this time, all I'm doing is I'm changing the hatching. Les hachures, c'est la seule chose que je change là. I'm just going in the direction of the fur. I might measure just to see where it ends. Light and shadow can be measured. Isn't that a zen thing to say? Thank you. So for this nose, the light is coming from above at an angle. So this part is lighter, this part is shaded, and nostrils, because they're holes, it's gonna be the darkest. So I'm gonna start just with the nostrils, and then do a light gray, except for on the top where the light is, and then adding a little bit. Maybe I'll make little circles like I did with the top of the tulip. And just refining the shape. Chaque fois que vous passez, vous pouvez changer un tout petit peu pour que ça ressemble un peu plus. Alors c'était des petits cercles gris. Lumière ici, un peu plus foncé en bas. Now, for these little bumps where the whiskers start, I'm just going to little diagonals, some larger than others. Je vais faire pour le début de la moustache des petits diagonales. J'invente un petit peu, I'm inventing a little bit. And again, if you don't want to do every single detail, just use the side of your pencil. I'm going to erase a bit to see what happens. These pupils, they're so scary. I'm gonna erase them. Je veux pas. Je vais le mettre là-bas. He's fixated by a bird up in the tree. Always change things midway. Got a bit dark there. Up. Okay, let's see the nose. This darkness is coming from the eyes. Ça vient de là. Et après, ça remonte. Eyes are like little lemons, that's what they're like. Comme des petits citrons. That's what I'm gonna call this cat. Citron. It's a cute name for a cat. Just gotta put Dark. Eraser is your best friend. La gomme, c'est votre meilleur ami. Après moi. Voilà. Je renforce. Adding a bit of depth, darkness. Gray here. Don't want it too white under the eyes. And now I'm going to show you the lights and the shadows in the cat's eyes. So as we said, the light is coming from there. So we see the light source there. Then most of the light is filtered in at the bottom, and here the brow is casting a shadow. Alors, il y a la lumière, le rehaut principal qui est là. Et puis il y a la plupart de la lumière qui vient ici. Après, il y a le front de ce chat qui donne un petit ombre sur les yeux. Alors, I'm just gonna show that there's a bit more fur up here. Je vais montrer qu'il y a un peu plus de poils ici. Sinon, on comprend pas pourquoi il y a un ombre. Ok. Et puis, je vais un tout petit peu mettre de gris. I'm gonna put a bit of gray here. Et puis, deuxième tour, it's around, I'm gonna go little diagonals, around, little diagonals, around, and at the top it's very dark, but c'est assez foncé, so I'm really adding some pressure, and this is gonna add beautiful depth to this cat's eyes. Still not convinced about my pupils, but I'll get there. Et puis, un peu de lumière en bas. Mais pas trop. Always blur out if there's too much of a barrier between colors. Just a light touch right at the bottom. Okay, and here too. Rounding out the lighty bits. And really digging in the dark. Give him a little bit more volume in his eyes. Also, always blur with your finger or with a blender, which I have today. Blender, toothpick, not toothpick, Q-tip. Satisfying tool. For these little details, these shading details. So here I'm starting to carve out these shapes. Il y a quelques formes que je vais commencer à dessiner en négatif. Alors, je colorie tout autour. Et là aussi pour les poils, je colorie tout autour des poils clairs. I'm just not gonna color in a couple of these lines. White line, I'm gonna just erase it. Another little white line. Okay. Even if you change the fur a little bit, what you want is the different parts to feel all connected. Alors même si vous changez un peu les poils, on veut que les différentes parties principales du visage se réunissent. So for example, this shadow connects the eyes to the face. This fur connects the ears to the face. It's overlapping. They're blending in together. Anything that happens here where things aren't touching, it's gonna matter a little bit less whether or not it connects. The shadow connecting the eye to the face a bit more. These fur lines help a bit. Even this line connecting. Every time my hand passes, you can use, on peut toujours utiliser ça. You can always use a paper towel if you don't want your hand to, then the graphite go there, but I am a little bit lazy when it comes to that. I don't mind erasing at the end. But yeah, so it just goes to show that these highlights, you can worry about them later because they're going to keep getting a little bit smudged in. So here I have a pointy corner left. I will show you what we can do with this for these whiskers. So let's say one starts over here. Just erasing it out. These can be a little haphazard as well. For the highlight here. Nice sense of depth to those eyes. The pointier this is, the thinner these whiskers will be. Le plus pointu, le quoi? Le plus fin. So, I'm gonna get out my cutter. Yep. Just cutting this little sliver off. Je coupe un tout petit fin bout. Four nice pointy corners. Super thin lines. So with these whiskers, you want one to go, a few of them to go over each other, otherwise it's going to look too detached. J'aimerais que la moustache passe un devant l'autre un petit peu, sinon ça a l'air trop séparé. Oh. Whoops. Là, je vais le faire en négatif. Here I made a mistake. Et on regarde. Got a little too excited there. Make one turn a bit more. How do we make the whiskers pop out over here? Légèrement, un petit trait en dessous. Très cassé, broken line. So, in order for to make those last touches, pour les tout petits derniers touches, retouches, pour les poils, les moustaches, to make these a bit more pointy and less clunky, pour que ça soit un peu plus pointu, je vais légèrement le tailler vers le haut surtout. Tac. Tac. Here's one, got a bit chunky. C'est devenu un peu large, alors je vais... Si on va léger, ça ne va rien changer pour les autres traits. Et, comme toujours, à la fin, effacer tout le gris. If you're not sure what eraser to get, I recommend Japanese Tombow Mono, best eraser out there. All the others will make your drawing dirtier or just won't erase as effectively. Je recommande la marque Tombow japonais pour les gommes. Il n'y a vraiment rien d'autre qui compare. Just last touches. Toute petite dernière touche. Avec la gomme. There we go. Citron. Thank you. Hope you liked it. See you next time.